Hey guys, Ben from Sunny's today, taking you for a walkthrough of the 23Zero Yowie rooftop tent. Hit it. The Yowie's got a roomy ABS shell over the top that allows space for your bedding to be packed inside, a luxurious inner for you to sleep in, and comes equipped with a few added extras just to make life a little more comfortable. We've got the 23Zero Yowie set up kind of in a back corner of the store here at the moment, so we're going to take you for a bit of a run through as best we can with the space we've got here. But we've got it set up here at the moment, but when it's packed up, the whole tent goes up sort of underneath here and this packs flat. So this measures 150 back this way, which would be along the length of the car, about 130 centimeters out here, including sort of the little brackets and things here. And height wise, when it's packed up, it's about 125 centimeters folded open, but when it packs down, it's about 35 centimeters from the top here to the bottom. We've got a lot more specific dimensions on our website to sort of explain how these things sort of line up with what I'm talking about here. And lengthwise, it's about 250 centimeters from this edge here right to the front edge there. And widthwise, by the time you set up these sort of awnings over the windows here, that adds about another 60 centimeters on each side. So this window also exists on the other side there. And altogether, it weighs about 79 kilos. So it's within the realms of what your normal or most rooftop tents are. But this kind of has a double folding mechanism, which we'll show you in a different video how to set it up, but it packs up inside here, which means it's got a smaller footprint, suitable for say dual cabs and that sort of thing. And when you set it up, it will be mounted such that this comes out the side of your vehicle. So it'll be mounted this way on the vehicle and it'll come out to the side of your vehicle. With regards to the fabrics that it's made of, 23Zero are continually improving their products, but always using really high quality materials. This is a really durable ripstop material that the main tent is made of, and it's got their LST backing on it. So this doesn't let any light through or blocks almost all light. So it's nice and dark inside the tent. The fly that sits over the top of this fabric is a 210D polyester that also has the black coating on the back of it there. So that gives a little bit of extra weather protection to the tent and also a bit of protection against things that drop on top of the tent. This is going to cop most of that. There's a TPU window in the top here, a skylight. We'll show you a bit more on that when we get inside. And looking at the mesh actually in the tent, there's the mesh panels are, they're a really durable mesh. It doesn't feel like it's a mesh that's going to get torn up and folded or get prickles and stuff caught in it. It feels like a really good balance of sort of a fine mesh that you can see through and offer good durability. The most interestingly is the case over the top here. This is a flexible ABS plastic case that sits down and encompasses all of this tent up underneath, and this folds flat. I'll show you that in the other video. The frame is mixed, sort of a combination of materials. There's this X-frame design here. So these are stainless steel frame here and gas struts that help with the setup of the tent. Aluminium base plate, so it's sort of a sandwiched aluminium here for mounting that only comes to halfway along the tent here, and also aluminium mounting rails underneath here. And you get a couple of these poles here, which are a steel sort of flexible pole for the awnings over the windows. There's a few other poles and things in there. They're all either steel or aluminium, sort of flexible round poles just for the structure. You can see when we do the setup video where all those poles sit. Now, a few inclusions with the tent. We can see down on the floor here, you get four of these. These are these metal poles here. So these two will do the window on the other side, and that comes in a bag. You get a couple of LED strip lights, which come in this case with a loop or like a Velcro fixing on the back here. There's a couple of spots in the tent that they can fix. We'll show you where they go shortly. And you get a few mounting options, firstly a spanner to help you put it all together, some brackets that you can use to in conjunction with the mounting things here, or the mounting rails here, sorry, to go either side of this, to sort of sandwich it onto your roof racks or roof rails with these bolts here. So these bolts actually fit inside the rail that's on the bottom here. Show you more on that in our setup video. And a few little extras, including caps that go on the end of the rails if any of these disappear, and some keys because you can actually lock it closed. So do a bit of a walkthrough of the Yowie now. Firstly, the configuration of the tent. Now, if this was sitting on a car, the car would be running that way. So that's the front and that's the back. And the shell folds out over the top of the passenger side of the vehicle. If I hold one of these poles up here, you can see that it comes out just a little bit further than the base plate, but it allows for space for a passenger side awning down here. You get about 5 centimeters of clearance between the edge of the base plate and where the shell comes to. Now this fabric is all attached with zippers here, so If anything does happen over time and you need to replace this, there's a zipper at the top here and a zipper here that runs all the way around, so you can replace the shell, but you shouldn't need to if you look after it. You're gonna get plenty of years of use out of it. So moving around, I won't go into details of all the mounting options. We've got another video for that, but we've got this window here, which is also featured on the other side of the tent here. So this is held out by these poles here, which just slot in the side. I'm gonna take these out to show you the window underneath. You don't have to have this set up, so you can actually just fold this up and put these up on the side here, or tuck these up here. So if you don't want to have shelter over the awning or over the window, you can put these away. Probably if you do have rain, that's going to give good protection. You can have this window open, and then this has got a mesh panel on the outside and a canvas panel or a solid panel on the inside here. Probably easier to do from the inside. There's the zip there. So you can see we can now access inside the tent there. Underneath that, a few flaps and things. Now these just all cover up the sort of mechanisms in the tent here. So there's sort of double layers and stuff here to try and cover that because it folds here. So 23Zero have just added some flaps and things over that to try and keep the weather out. If it rains, it goes over the top and you're not going to get too much wind and stuff in there. So moving on from that, we come up to this section here, which is all part of the fly sheet that sits over the top here. That's attached up the top of the tent up in here by the zipper. You can't remove this, it stays on all the time. And there's a strap here that's part of the setup pack down sort of process to be able to pull this cover down. TPU mirror, window in the top there. We'll show you more of that when we get inside. And you've got this mesh panel here, which lines up with, if I just jump across in front of you, a panel inside here. So you can be folded up to the top to allow a bit of extra airflow through here. Or if you want to protect it against wind and or any sort of breeze coming through here, you can close it right up. There is still gaps up here, so you will still get a bit of airflow through here, but it does offer a rain protected space to stand under to crawl into the tent. Before we go any further, a couple of other things. They've got the frame that sits up around here. So this loophole is another thing. I don't know exactly what that's made of, but I believe it's a steel frame with extendable or lockable sections here. It's all part of the pack up and setup. So you do have to put this up each time you set the tent up. And one of the other extras you get with the Yowie are these boot bags. There's two of them, one on each side here. This just allows you to get up, sit inside the tent here, put your boots in the bag here, so they're up off the ground. You've got a few other storage pockets for things in there. Seal it up, close it up. It's weatherproof as well, or reasonably weatherproof. If you tighten this loop up here and then do the loop over the top, it's going to keep most of the rain out. And that way you can keep your boots safe and easy to access when you get up in the morning. The ladder here is attached via bolts. You don't actually remove this. It folds up inside the tent and stays attached to it. And we can't extend this now because it's set up down really low, but this just goes up and down. There are little locking points up underneath here. And this actually forms part of the structure of the tent. So this leans on the ground to give support to this side of the tent because this will be coming out the side of the car. So just above the ladder is this Velcro hook strip, hook and loop strip that you can use in conjunction with the Velcro LED strips here. Now before I put that on, I just want to mention you can actually, these come with these strips, but you can actually replace them if need be. It's just a strip with a loop backing on it, PVC on the front there, and you can slide in any strip light. So if you want to get orange light strip lights, you can put them in replacement. But then that just attaches on here, and you've got probably, I reckon it's a bit over 2 meters of cord attached to this here, so you can lead that through your tent, around the side or whatever, wherever you want, to a power source, the USB power source, to power light under your awning here. Now there's a second one of those, as mentioned before, that goes at the back of the tent. I'm just going to throw that in here and I'll show you where that goes in a minute. So we're crawling inside the tent. Now I've got a light in here that's just a 240 volt light from the shop, so we can see what's going on because of this dark chrome coating in here and the plastic backing on it. There's not much light inside here, so got this here to try and show you inside. But what I'm sitting on here is a 65 centimeter foam mattress. It's a reasonably firm foam mattress that feels comfortable. As I'm sitting on it now, I can sort of push through to the bottom, but by the time I'm lying on it, the weight would be evenly distributed and it would feel quite comfortable. It's got a velour top on it. It's quite a sort of a thick velour top on it and a synthetic backing on it. And in the corners, it's got little side release buckles that line up with the clip down on the base here, so you can actually clip it in place so it doesn't move around for pack up. That's just in the front or in at this end of the tent. They don't exist at the other end, and it probably just helps to stop this mat from sliding when it's folded up. I'm just going to put this light down here to try and get some light in the tent, because I want to talk about the dimensions in here. So lengthwise, it's about 196 centimeters. So this end here is quite upright, and that end slopes a little bit. So you've got pretty good use of that full 196 centimeters of length and about 130 centimeters in width. Now, with regards to height, I'm 185 centimeters, so I'm sitting here cross-legged quite comfortably with plenty of headspace. It's about a meter to sort of this point here. This sags down a little bit there. And then this is where the hard shell backing is. There's like a foam on the inside of the ABS plastic, and that tucks up a little bit higher to about 110 centimeters on this side here. So having a general look at all the features inside, we'll start on this side here. So this is the side that we didn't have the awning set up on. So you can see you've got inner window here and then the outer mesh there, which then looks out to that outer sort of awning that we could reach out this window and put those flexible poles in place. You have got another pole here that runs right around the top. That's all part of the structure, or the folding structure. So moving further to the back of the tent here, and I'll bring the light with me because it's quite dark in here. We've got a little storage pocket. This is fixed on here, or two pockets on this side here for a bit of storage at night. Further to the back, starting at the base, you've got a vent here. So there's vents on all sides. You've got the windows on each side. This low-level vent here, that opens up to a mesh panel, and then the mesh panel opens up so you can get to outside the tent. So it's a bit dark out there, but that's looking outside completely to the tent there. And then above that is the second Velcro strip that runs along here, if you can see that. And that's where we can mount second LED strip. So I can just attach that on there. And there's a little Velcro tab here for me to be able to just put the cord through so that it doesn't pull directly on the side of the light strip there. And you've got that almost 2 meters of cable here, which will run right to the other end of the tent there. Or you can tuck it out the window, or even you can tuck it through where the actual hinge occurs on the tent. There's enough space to get a cord down through there. Probably just worth making sure you remove it before you fold it up so it doesn't get caught up in the mechanisms. So down the other side of the tent here, we've got two more pockets here for storage for the person on this side of the tent. Forward to that, another one of those windows. This is the one that would open out into that awning that we had set up previously. And looking up above that, sort of talking about the roof, this is the underside of the ABS plastic, and there's a little bit of foam here, so it's a slightly padded sort of material, so I guess a bit of noise suppression. Feels quite nice and firm, all sort of laminated to that plastic. And you can also see while I'm here that all of this is seam sealed, so inside here, along the roof here, and also down around the sides, you can see around the windows, this is all seam sealed, so it's all waterproof. The fly itself has got a 3000 millimeter waterhead rating. We don't actually have a waterhead rating for this, but I can assure you it's going to keep you more than dry, any of this fabric. It's a durable fabric. Now, the roof vent, moving forward a little bit, we've got this double sort of panel here, so this is closed completely at the moment. I can actually unzip this and roll this up if I like, and I've now got that mesh panel there, and that's still waterproof, because above that, if I undo this one as well, which I can do, and you can see that we've got this PVC panel here that gives us waterproof protection, so we can actually have this completely open if we like, looking at the storm clouds raining down upon us while we're sleeping inside the tent. Now, the last door that I haven't referred to is the one that we came through at the start, and that's this one here, which also has double panels. So you've got the mesh panel here and then a solid panel here. And 23Zero I've actually included, I will undo this to show you, in the bottom of this, a hard sort of ridge here. So instead of putting Velcro along the bottom of here, there's a flexible pole in there, and that holds this down firm, or stops it from flapping around too much down against the edge of the tent there. Now, one other thing that I do want to mention, well, I may have mentioned before, is that you can actually leave a little bit of bedding inside the Yowie when you pack it up. So this section here that I'm sitting on now actually folds up onto this section here, and it comes to about, you can see the fold sections here, so it comes to sort of about here, which means you've got a bit of space at the end there, sort of 35 centimeters height in space, just to leave some bedding and pillows. So you put all your bedding up that in there, and then you fold this closed. Now, we should test that, or show you a little bit more on that in our setup and pack down video. So check that out if you want to know a bit more information on that. That is the 23Zero Yowie ABS Hard Shell Rooftop Tent. It's the perfect option for people who've got, say, a dual cab and want to fit it within the confines of the trailer in the back, or perhaps a vehicle with a smaller roof space because it's got a smaller footprint. It does sit up a bit higher, but you can fit the bedding inside, and it packs up really easily with that inside as well. You can see us do that in our pack down and setup video, so check that out for a bit more info. You can find these online at our lowest prices every day at snowies.com.au. You'll find all the details on dimensions on there as well. But if you do have any questions, let us know down in the comments below. Subscribe to our channel for all of our latest and greatest information, or check out some other awesome 23Zero products like this one down here.